7525
was originally built for the Burlington Northern Railroad. And if you remember, I said that railroads would buy engines from other companies, and when the Burlington Northern was finished with it, the Wisconsin Central purchased the 7525. Its paint literally today is in the Operation Lifesaver paint scheme, and we want to remind everyone that Operation Lifesaver is an effort by the railroads to make everybody cognizant of railroad safety and safety when you're around railroad tracks. Remember to look both ways before crossing tracks and never, never, never step on the rail. The 92 is a very distinctive locomotive. The 92 was built in 1967. Division of General Motors in the Greenwich, Illinois, and it was one of a group of 10 locomotives and the last locomotives that were built exclusively for passenger service. The Santa Fe bought 10 of these for the crack train, the Super Chief from El Capitan, and they had these on their famous passenger trains until the advent of Amtrak in 1971. The paint scheme that's on the 92 is very distinctive. It was developed by an EMD designer in 1938 for the new orders of locomotives for the Santa Fe. It's called the Red Bonnet paint scheme. And this scheme was used on the 10 passenger engines that were built in 1967, this one, and then adopted by the Santa Fe in 1990 for the scheme for the new super fleet. Folks, the engineer on the 7525 and the Santa Fe 92 is Ray Rue. Ray is a longtime volunteer here and a professional railroad. He's also somewhat of a whistle artist, known as a whistle artist here at the Illinois Railway Museum. So, kids, cover your ears now, because Ray's merciless. Cover your ears, and Ray's going to blow horns and pass in review. The train that Ray is pulling today is an example of many of the freight cars in the Illinois Railway Museum collection. All of these cars are obsolete cars today.